Hi, I'm Mike Marin, and in this video, we'll discuss making stratified boxplots. Stratified boxplots are useful for examining the relationship between a categorical variable and a numeric variable within strata or groups formed by a third variable that's categorical. We will examine the relationship between smoking and lung capacity within age groups or age strata. We will be working with the lung capacity data that was introduced earlier in this series of videos. I've already imported this data into R and attached it. I've also already created an age group variable. This variable has taken the age variable and created a new categorical representation of it using age categories of less than 13, 14 to 15, 16 to 17, and 18 plus. We can see that the age of 6 is in the age group category less than 13. The age of 18 is in the 18 plus category, and so on. We can also see that this variable has four categories or levels. To learn more about converting a numeric variable to a categorical variable using the cut command, you can watch the following video here. In the previous video in this series, we discussed making boxplots. First, we learned how to make a boxplot for a single variable. Let's take a look at doing this for lung capacity. We can make a boxplot of the lung cap. We can set a Y label of lung capacity. We can also add a title. Let's call this box plot of lung cap. And I like to set the LAS argument equal to 1 to have the values on the y-axis rotated. We also learned how to create side-by-side box plots to compare groups. Let's take a look at one of these comparing the lung capacity for smokers and non-smokers. To do this, we use the tilda here. And this will produce a box plot of lung capacity for smokers and for non-smokers separately. Let's also change this title here to call it lung cap versus smoking. For a more thorough discussion of creating box plots, you can watch the previous video in this series here. We can see that the smokers have a larger lung capacity on average, which is counterintuitive. A topic we'll explore more in later videos is the idea of confounding. For now, we will briefly mention that the smoking effect is confounded with the age effect. Recall, these children are aged 3 to 19 years old. On average, the smokers are older than the non-smokers. And the older children have bigger bodies and therefore they have bigger lung capacities. And this is what is causing us to observe this counterintuitive relationship. Given this, one option we can consider is examining the relationship between smoking and lung capacity within age strata. For example, we could look at this relationship for only the 18-year-olds or older. As outlined in the earlier video on box plots, we can use the square brackets to do this. Here, we can take the lung capacity and only use those whose age is greater or equal to 18. And again, smoking, only those whose age is greater or equal to 18. And here we'll look at lung capacity versus smoking for the 18-plus-year-olds. When we do this, we now observe a more intuitive relationship. Within the 18 plus age strata, smokers have a lower lung capacity than non-smokers. To learn more about the use of square brackets, you can watch this video here on subsetting data using square brackets. We could do this separately for all different age strata using the previous command, but it's a bit nicer to see them all on the same plot. Recall that I've already created a categorical age group variable and introduced this at the start of the video. As a reminder, let's just take a look at the first 5 ages. Let's also take a look at the first 5 age groups. And again, a reminder of the levels for this variable age group. We can see that there are 4 age categories or 4 age strata that we'll work with. Now, we will want to produce box plots to visualize the relationship between lung capacity and smoking within each of these age strata. That is, we'll want box plots of the lung capacity for smokers and for non-smokers who are in the 13 or younger age group. We'll also want box plots of lung capacity for smokers and non-smokers in the 14 to 15-year-old age group, and so on, all appearing on one plot. Now let's go back to that box plot command we entered earlier. Within this command, we can use the smoking times the age group. What this will do is it will take the 2 smoking categories, yes and no, and cross them with the 4 age group categories, less than 13, 14 to 15, 16 to 17, and 18 plus, to produce 8 separate box plots, one for each combination of smoking category and age group category. Let's also go ahead and edit that title, and let's call it Lung Capacity versus Smoke by Age Group. We can see the 8 box plots here. You can also notice the x-axis labels are overlapping each other, and therefore we don't see them all. So we can go ahead and rotate the values on the x-axis by setting the LAS argument equal to 2 instead of 1. Now we can see all of those names nicely. We can see the first box plot is for the non-smokers who are in the 13 or less age group. The second box plot are the smokers in the 13 or less age group. That third box plot is the non-smokers in the 14 to 15 age group, and so on. We can now visualize how smokers compare with non-smokers within each of the age strata by comparing box plots that are next to each other. And finally, we can use colors to help separate the groups visually a bit better. I will use color number 4, or blue, for non-smokers, and color number 2, or red, for smokers. To do this, all we need to do is add in the color argument, and we'll use color 4 and color 2. And having only specified 2 colors and 8 box plots to be produced, R will recycle the colors, using blue, then red, then blue, then red, and so on. We can see that within age strata, smokers tend to have a lower lung capacity than non-smokers. Quite a different conclusion than when we examine the relationship between smoking and lung capacity, ignoring age. Now, we can clean up the x-axis and strata names a little bit if we like. I've prepared a script of code to do this, so I will go ahead and just submit these commands and make this plot look a little bit nicer. And I would suggest that you can watch the following two videos if you'd like to learn a bit more about modifying plots, relabeling axes, adding legends, and so on. So the first thing we can do is produce this plot again, then we can add a box around it. We can relabel the y-axis, relabel the x-axis, and add in the legend there, letting the viewer know that the blue indicates non-smokers and the red indicates smokers. Thanks for watching this video. Make sure to check out our other instructional videos and subscribe to our channel.